Good afternoon, countrymen and women, and all those who are watching us. I want to address the nation and the other interested parties to say that today the Ndola High Court has stayed the whole matter in which suspended Vice President Akafumba and his group went to get an ex parte injunction to restrain me from being president of the National Democratic Congress. And this was on the backdrop that they had sued me twice in the Lusaka High Court. And when the Lusaka High Court ordered for inter-party hearing, they decided to withdraw the matter and go to Ndola. That in law is known as forum shopping. Now, what we have done is that we ask the Ndola High Court to stay that matter and make these people pay the costs that we incurred in the Lusaka court in order for them to be allowed to go ahead with their case. That means that as things stand now, I am still the president of the National Democratic Congress, and the party runs as normal. Our colleagues remain expelled from the party. And I want to say this, that this should be a learning curve. It should be a lesson to all those who think they can use underhand methods to obtain a relief even when they are not entitled to that kind of relief. Our colleagues knew that with an inter-party hearing, they stood no chance of winning the case because they don't have any legal basis for what they were doing. But they decided to go on forum shopping from one court to the other, from one court to the other. And I said last time I addressed the nation that that was a very temporary relief. And I have said before, and I want to say it again, when you are starting a war, assess the risk, because imbwidi ni imbwidi. You cannot just start a war and expect to win when you have no legal backing or legal basis on which to base your actions. Now, the ordering of them to pay the costs should teach them a lesson that you cannot abuse the court process. You cannot use the court to try and legalize an illegality. It doesn't work out that way. And surely, I have told these people, they will not, and they will never, never, never grab NDC from its members and the general public. Because NDC was not created for Mr. Mumbi. NDC was not created for Chishimba Kambui. NDC was not created for Mr. Akafumba. Neither was it created for Mrs. Atanga, but it was created for all the members, and therefore only the members through their central committee and through the convention can decide who becomes president of that political party. You can't sit, the five of you, and decide that we have removed the president and I am acting president. What kind of behavior is that? What kind of law is that? You avoid to go and sit as a central committee. You go and sit, the five of you. You appoint yourselves. This one is spokesperson. This one is vice president. And by the way, with due respect, you can't be 2 months old in the party and claim to be vice president. You can't be 2 months old. You want to ascend to the position of vice president. Where I come from, where I've come from, they say, umweni takokota mafupa. Umweni takokota mafupa. Pagwadi. Ngama umfale kokota mafupa, minisho kwa fuma mina fiaya tunturu. Elo kabili chive mbachine, chitila umweni talisha munsoli. Munga ndaya mwini. Ngama umfale lisho munsoli, minisho kwa fuma, ningomba. Literally meaning when somebody, before, when somebody visits you and starts bringing confusion, immediately comes, just know that this man is naturally a troublesome person. You can't come to Mumbini NDC 3 months old. I give you an opportunity to serve as presidential spokesperson. You bring so much confusion and you start saying, Kambwid is not a member of NDC, he's not a president of NDC, we fire him. This is what you did to Mr. Sata. You insulted Mr. Sata. And by the way, people of Zambia, you must know that when Mr. Mumbi joined us and we went for a meeting with HH, he refused. HH refused, I cannot have a meeting with you guys as long as Mumbi is there. I had to plead with HH and say, look, you cannot base Mumbi's behavior on past experiences that you had with him. He's my man and he's in my team who come for the meeting. But Nifidi Abantu Balanda, who are quoting for Yakwano Komutanch, I wished I'd listened from Mr. HH. And again, myself, I'm also telling Mr. HH, President HH, that my dear brother, the same way he insulted Basata, the same way he's insulting me, is going to insult you. Because that man has proved to be a problem. Umweni, umweni, takokotama fupa, pawadi. Na mwamfale kokotama fupa, ni nshokwa fumamina fiaya tunturu. And for you, my elder brother, in whom I respect so much, my elder sister, Mrs. Atanga, what you are doing is not correct. I don't know what has come into you people. You have disparaged me. You have insulted me. You said all sorts of things. I don't answer you. It's not that I'm not capable of answering back, but it's because this thing is not about who insults who says what. It's just about following the law. And the law is very clear. We have a constitution, and that's why we exist as NDC. If we didn't have a constitution, as you are claiming, we couldn't have been registered at a registrar of society. We couldn't be existing. But today, you are saying we have no constitution. If we don't have a constitution, on which basis are you basing to say you have expelled me? On which basis are you saying you have replaced the leadership? Which law are you using? So this should be a lesson, that you cannot grab something that is not yours. Ichi shiri chove, te chove, tachakabata chive chove, kaita chakabe chove. I hope you've learned a lesson from what has happened. And I want to thank the Ndola High Court for being magnanimous and make a decision in the right direction. So to all our members, I am still the president of the NDC. And next weekend, not this coming weekend, we are going to have our convention, which was postponed as a result of this setback. I want to thank everybody, and God bless Zambia.